Thank you so much for speaking to me, team Ramola. And since I'd spoken to Sanvi before.
Yes, nice to see you again.
I am first going to start, likewise. So I'm going to start with Lakshmi Manchu, who I had spoken to, a few months back. And, she was creating content. And when we had discussed, she came across as this very strong woman who, stands up for everything, right? And then I see her character and I do
because I'm an actor and I steal identities of people. That's what pays my bills. And I'm glad I made you feel like that because I did right by the character and the role that was given to me, I am not what I do. They're two separate people.
Absolutely.
But having said that, in India, people look at you for what you do. You have to be the person as this. You're a hero means only hero. You can't play like all these other roles. For me, I have to constantly tell people that because they put me on every TV show I do. They think that's who I am. I'm like, no. Mm-hmm. So I think you gave me the biggest compliment starting off because I did justice to what Tarun had written for Swarupaka.
And, honestly, because, the conversation I had with Lakshmi, and had she been Lakshmi, she would have stood up for the cause of Ramula. Like, what there? And I'm like, So I want to say it's a very emotional narrative. And Tarun, I want to ask you, from the urban space, you've gone to rural Telangana. I know there are stories like that. Was there some incident that triggered this off for you to, write this narrative and bring it to light again?
Yes, ma'am. So there have been events like this, and I've been hearing it for quite some time. But the only thing that I couldn't digest is how lightly we just took it, because we were talking about people here, and we were talking about grave incidents happening to people related to that event. So I just wanted to explore how we could bring these characters to real life and go into their world and see how they took their decisions.
And Sanvi, I know you told me last time that you were the new kid and you're just like happy with, with OTT, just very thankful. It's like a playground, you described it.
Yeah.
So when Ramula came to you, what was your first reaction and what was your takeaway?
Okay, so first, when Tarun told me the story, I felt he has written it for me. And the character, the story, of course, he's known for this sense of storytelling, and apart from that, Netflix is releasing its first Telugu content. So, and it's known for its amazing content. So, delivering amazing content. So, I think I was really fortunate to be associated to Netflix and a wonderful director like Tarun. And an amazing character where I can actually showcase my skills. So I feel blessed, nothing less or more.
Naveen, now since this is the story about Ramula,
yes,
I mean, one first looks at you like, he's just going to cause trouble, and then you feel bad for him also. kind of like, poor thing. So what was it like for you?
What was it like
for you, understanding the character, like the story?
Yeah, the story. I've seen many characters like Ramchandar in my life too. And when he narrated the story, what I understood from his storytelling is like Ramchandar is he's a free fellow. Like he has no boundaries. He has nothing to do with his life. He feels like he's a man, but he is a useless fellow. In the starting, and he's scared of his father and he's scared of his girlfriend too, but he can't go out of her. He loves her so much. So he's a sensible fellow and he's an innocent. And but the thing is, the problem with him is he can't, say whatever he wants to. Like, he likes this girl, but he can't say it in front of his father. That's his weakness. But by the time he becomes stronger, the things changed in his life. So, the character, when he narrated me, I thought about only those things, like how when I talk to my dad, I don't speak much. He only talks everything and I don't speak much. That I converted in this character. So when he told me like you should not talk anything with your dad, then my dad came into the picture and I acted in that way. So that's how I performed the character. Like I took real incidents and my friends' resemblances and I used their,
body mannerisms and all.
Yeah, right? Their mannerisms and I implemented it to the character. And that's how Ramchandar
came to life.
Lakshmi, you tell me, who was your takeaway? Who did you observe?
She's not revealing yet.
I wish I could just say the name. I think people who see it and who know me will know exactly who I was trying to portray. Jokes apart, for a woman I still fight in this industry, being Mohan Babu's daughter, to be relevant. Or, you know, the biggest of the directors have come to me and told me, only if you were a man. Like, and it breaks my heart. So I am not where I need to be because I'm a woman, not because of my talent, not because of what I can deliver, because I'm not a man. I heard and hear that over and over and over again, you know, and it is like I'm like a salmon. I'm swimming against the tide, I feel like. But this is my purpose and this is my journey. And if I can do what I'm doing and have the shoulders for other women to stand up on me and on my shoulders, then I'm here. Because I have the zeal, I have the conviction, and I'm not going to let those people put me down. Really looking at Swarupakka, being in that village, trying to make a mark for herself. She's constantly humiliated in spite of being, you know, Mahila Mandali. And so how do you get back at them? How do you do that? I mean, so it's always a power play. And how does she get into that power play? And I think her intention was to help Ramla really and say, let's put that guy in the bad light, you know, and you stand up for yourself, I'm here. And if Ramla had the patience, things maybe would have turned out differently, but we don't know that, you know. Emotions come into play and everything takes a different turn. I mean, he really doesn't show Swarupakka how she took that with Ramla's decision. So it's all open-ended, you know, and it's left up to interpretation. So that's what I loved about it. Like, you know, when you come away from a movie and said, could this have been this way, or they should have done that, or why did she do this, or why did he do that, then you made a great film, you know, rather than somebody saying, oh, it was good. I don't want it to be, it was good. I want to rile up feathers and be like, how could they do this? Or how could she do that? And I think Tarun did a brilliant job in creating those layers in each of our characters.
I so agree with you. You know, how could they do it? Because that anger is there. But my issue with directors is, why do they leave this open end? Because viewers like me get totally like frazzled. We can't sleep. We are thinking. Like,
that's what you want.
You know, I have spent sleepless nights.
Yes.
I spent sleepless nights thinking about, like, should I've had that alternate ending, you know? Why do you not do that? Why do you all do that? Yeah.
No, ma'am.
For the same exact reason.
No, quite honestly, to really leave, I would like to be shocked by a film that I've seen for 30 minutes. If it's a two-hour film, then you're always resolving all the graphs and you want a gratifying end. Because when you get up from the theater and you walk out, you feel fulfilled. And there's a certain way you structure it. But when you're watching something short, it has to be something that leaves impact, starts conversations amongst our friends and everything. And probably that shock is what probably alters your perception also towards things.
And that's a reality, ma'am. That's been happening.
Yeah, that's a reality.
So he wanted to show that.
Yeah. So what happens is, let's talk like this. I mean, if you read this news article that so-and-so happened, so-and-so thing happened, we just take it lightly. But now that you know that he has a problem with the father, his father's concerned about his well-being, her brother is basically looking out for her and she's being controlled by a group of men on stage. Now you feel for the characters, now you know they're real, and now when you read that incident, it hits you somewhere. That level of empathy only filmmaking can do, because we just talk about people. Even if our house help or somebody comes and tells their problems, we empathize on a very superficial level. But what if we were born in their household? What if we had a window to look at them, be in their shoes, see their difficulties for what they are? It leaves a very different impact. And that was the whole thing.
But Tarun, how come you didn't act in this?
Hello, excuse me. Give us also a chance. This man's directing, writing, screenplay, now become an actor also. Hello.
No, but he does, no? He does act on and off.
So he does. That's what I said. Hello, give us a chance also a little bit.
No, but
you only do acting.
No, but...
enough.
But I have a very, very...
You're a producer also.
I know. I have to produce my own film because nobody else will cast.
No, but I have a very clear idea on this, ma'am. As in... When I write and I'm directing, I cannot focus on what the actors are doing, because the actors also are a part of the entire process. So the moment I told Lakshmi ma'am her character, for those 10 days, she was doing pre-production in her head. We assume that, all right, setting up the cameras and everything is work. It's all logistical work, but there's a lot of mental prep going on. And imagine if you're directing and acting, that's a whole new game.
That only Kamal Haasan sir can do it.
Yeah, I guess. Very. I mean,
can
that's
sing, dance, choreograph, music, everything. Fight, everything. One man show.
Totally. And also now, Lakshmi, as you said, you know, I produced, but no one's buying my film. But now, with, you know, a lot of filmmakers and producers have had this problem in cinema due to distribution, because will it cater, box office numbers. But do you think now with this platform, many of you have said it gives us creative liberties as actors, as content creators, that we can present various stories?
Not just that, Pooja. For me as a producer, if you're asking me, I will deliver the most amazing story to you. But then I have zero control over distribution and the exhibitors. They give me a paper of these many seats were sold. The distributor says one thing. We just have to believe in it. There are very few players in that, and that hasn't really been monetized to really help the producers even today. So a platform like an OTT platform like Netflix or Amazon, in my mind, I don't want to make a theatrical film. I don't want to go through that pressure of business and when will the theaters be open? How many theaters am I going to get? Will my movie get bumped because there is another big heroes movies coming in spite of my movie doing well? Why should I, like, nobody's given their due credit, I feel, you know, in that aspect. So with this, I'm in 190 countries, like, you know, with like 200 odd million subscribers. Why would I want to make a theatrical film that'll show in like 100 theaters? No need. I'm very, as a filmmaker, I want people to see the film. It doesn't matter if they're seeing in a theater or elsewhere. I think we can give that experience, and you've had that experience watching our show. So I think different mediums have truly given us freedom, not just in storytelling, but also on the business aspect of it.
Also, adding to that, ma'am, actually, adding to what Lakshmi ma'am said, so what's happened now is there's a huge data revolution, right? So before, theatrical distributors only relied on just the audience pulse, which was just based out of the experience in the theater. But now we are backed up by data. OTT is backed up by data, because now these people know what the target audience is, what kind of people are coming and watching it, their age, their sex, their income, and, you know, where they're watching it from. So now you clearly know what story has what market. It's not like a shot in the dark, like the theater. So now we know that women are watching this content, and this much of women are watching it. So now you know that market exists. And if you're talking about rural stories, these many people are watching it or they have interest in it. So this data just clears it and puts light onto the whole thing. Absolutely. So that enables business better.
True. And asking Sanvi and Naveen, both of you, Sanvi called OTT a happy space.
Yes.
Because, you know, she's starting her journey at a time where the lines have gotten blurred. You know, no longer you're a film actor, TV actor, OTT actor, you are an actor.
Yes.
And If you're deserving, you will get it. So, Sanvi, exciting times, and then we'll ask Naveen.
Yeah, what is it again?
So she said, is it exciting times? Like just being
yeah. So I've said it's a happy place because I think with the OTTs, it's more like it's open to more employment, where we have more talents coming up, more content, and more opportunities. And with that, I think for first-time filmmakers or music composers or DOPs, I think they all now know, they can discern between what kind of output to be delivered to OTT and what kind of output to be delivered to theatres. So I think it's the scope is so widened, and for actors, they have they're having a lot of opportunities to be there. You know, earlier it wasn't like that. It was very, you know, I think it was circumscribed. But right now, I think the lot of opportunity is coming in, and now we can just happily, you know, take part. So that's exactly why I called. It's a happy place.
And you can see the happiness on your face despite doing such a serious role. Look at the happiness.
Yeah.
This is what I would want to see all the Ramulas to be like.
Oh, happy. Yes. Yeah. That does. Yeah.
And also, I think every story has its own audience. And with the platforms like these, it's got a wider section of audience to reach.
The whole world is your playground now, literally.
Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
And Netflix,
Naveen,
what about you? 200 million subscribers, I think. What else do we need?
I know. You are a hit.
Yeah, ma'am. So one good thing with the OTT is like when you're watching a film, if you don't like at one point, you'll pause it, you'll take a break, and you'll again come back and you'll watch the film. And if you want to watch it again, you can watch n number of times. So as an actor, I'm very thankful to be part of Netflix and all the OTT platforms because it gives me n number of characters. I can explore myself. I don't have boundaries. I don't have limitations. I can do whatever I want because that's the beauty with OTT. I'm least bothered about for which platform I'm doing, whether it is a film or YouTube. I even work for short films. I only thing is actor. My part is acting for the character. And I'll do whatever, like if you want me to act for a YouTube channel, I'll do it. Only if I like the character. So, because of these OTT platforms, we are getting so many, opportunities. That's the best part for every craft, not only acting, for every, as a director, as a creator, he can explore. He don't have limitations. He don't have the, you know, the instructions, like you should not show this, you should not show that. And the actor, like, so that's the best part with OTT, and I want all these platforms to encourage new talent so that so many youngsters, so many newcomers who are waiting for opportunity, they'll get opportunity and let the world see their talent also. So I'm very thankful to Netflix and all the other OTT platforms.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you so much. And before we go, I want to ask Lakshmi and Tarun, what do you think about censorship on OTT?
So that's what ma'am, previously also mentioned a couple of places. When it's theatrical films, there's a certification process because when you're setting up something in public, then you have a certain social etiquette to mind. So we cannot have something very, very racial or suddenly which can enrage the mob into creating chaos in a theater, which is why we had certification process. But now with OTTs, just like Abhay mentioned, you have the power to pause, rewind, forward, watch it in the first place, or just stop watching it, close it, and read about it, see the trailer and everything, and you have complete control. When you have it and it's private watching, if you censor that also, then you're stubbing the voice of so many people. So that shouldn't happen. And internet is all about democracy. So that is why it was created. The power of information right now is really lighting up the entire nation. At such a stage, if we want to have political control over it, or for some reason, that is absolutely not right, and I don't think that's democracy at all.
It's like killing so many voices.
Yeah.
Yeah. Freedom of expression.
Yes.
Yeah. And let's not do that to internet at least.
Please. Yeah. It is really truly freedom of expression, and it's there. You have different profiles, right? My daughter has her own profile, so when she clicks on it, automatically it removes the content that she's not ready to watch.
Absolutely.
So, and I've been saying this over and over again, as artists, we have to make people uncomfortable, make them think and push through their boundaries. And I think OTT platforms have given us a voice as such.
Let's use technology to create personal filters, but not censor content. That's all.
They are trying for censorship because we are trying to show reality.
Yeah.
So that shouldn't happen.
Thank you so much. At least for OTT. Thank you so much for absolutely agree with you. Thank you so much for speaking to me. And Lakshmi is all set to go on a 100-kilometer cycle race.
yes. Yes.
More power.
Thank you. Thank you, Pooja. Thank you so much.
So are you going to make, which is that one movie that you want to make now? A character you want to play Lakshmi?
Me?
Lakshmi, ma'am.
Oh, yeah. As I said, the world is a stage for me. I'm going to get a call right after this film comes out. Netflix LA is going to call me and put me in a series there, and I'm buying me a one-way ticket. That's what's happening.
Tarun, what are you going to make?
I don't know, ma'am. I'm just waiting for the next story that inspires me. I'll keep it open.
True. All the very best. More power to you. And thank you for bringing such a sensitive story to our screens.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Pooja. Thank you. This is great.
Bye-bye. Bye.